What was the first thing you did this morning? Exactly when you wake up. Try to remember. Probably you heard the buzz of a notification. You pick up your phone and you start scrolling through an infinite list of information. From top to bottom, from the present to the past, from the things near you to the things far away. We travel on our phone for 22 meters every day. Our fingers are constantly moving. Our eyes are constantly searching for the next image. And Facebook, Instagram, newsfeed, we do the same things on any social media. We scroll, we leave trace of our passage, and in return, we receive immediate gratification. Our behavior online is not random at all. There is a correlation between what we see online and how we act. When I'm bored, I cannot help but see some of the 60 million images that are uploaded every day on Instagram. When I receive a notification, I cannot help but see who is the sender across of the 30 billion messages that are exchanged every day on WhatsApp. And when I'm commuting to work, I cannot help but view who watch my profile across the 500 million professionals on LinkedIn. There is a word of Latin origin that defines this inability to stop doing something. And this word is addiction. I influence your behavior creating incentives. And over the time, I build a system, a potentially dangerous system of motivation that in some way stop you from thinking and create addiction. Imagine chocolate, sugar, tobacco. And I thought it was a game at the beginning. I thought you were able to self-regulate yourself using a simple willpower. But then I realized that I was wrong. Then I realized that you were not able to control the tools that I built for you. Since we started this talk, so a few minutes ago probably, already 1 billion advertising impressions have been delivered. Already 100 million email has been sent. And already 8 million views has been watched on YouTube. The application that design stimulate your appetite, and you constantly want another shot in progressively bigger quantities. Well, I design products that are rooted in your mind because they rely on your memory, and they rely on your cognitive bias. I look inside your unmet needs, and that there's an interface that finally are familiar, intuitive, and convenient for you. I make products that they make you feel invincible, but in reality, you forgot that you are limited in your time. There is something that we unlocked, and is your habit. And we unlock the way you create your habit using a simple loop of three events: the trigger, the routine, and the reward. What is the trigger? The trigger is the signal that generates your action. So they catch your attention, this signal. For example, is when you receive a notification or an emotional condition, when you are bored, or when you wake up in the morning. The routine is the action you do when you see this signal. So, for example, you receive a notification and you click to see who sent this one. Or you wake up in the morning and you check the email, isn't it? So this is the routine, and then there is the trigger. And the trigger is what reinforces this habit, because it releases dopamine in your mind. It's when you receive a sort of reward. So that's the reward. And the reward is basically when you post on your wall and someone likes it, or someone starts following you, or someone writes a comment, a positive comment to your post. You were on the cover of 2006 Time magazine. You were on the cover of 2006 Time magazine. You were the person of the year. Amazing, isn't it? And you were in control of the information age. But then, what's happened after? 2007, the phone. 2009, the notification. 2013, Instagram follower. 2017, YouTube autoplay. And this now seems like a mirage. You are the product. And every day I monitor, influence, and distract you. A few years ago, I had the opportunity to move on from the media space to focus on an education product, on a game-based platform. I was thrilled. It was my opportunity to build something for a good cause. And so I started to do what I know to do. Rework on the interface and improving the experience and growing the audience on the product and using my skill to motivate the user, in this case the student, to spend more time on the product for a good cause, because in this case it was for learning more. But I've done all of this, so I started reaching the cognitive process of the student using all I know and what all technology can offer me. So notification, daily challenging, adaptive content, and reward, like, for example, medal, notification, medal, and level, and points. So all was going good. The product was asking more activity to the user, and the user was spending more time on the product. And engagement was going up, 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 and everybody was happy. Parents, students, teachers, my clients, because the engagement was high. But then I start to notice in the flip side. The student cannot stop playing. I had to implement a block after 45 minutes continuous play to give them some rest. And then it was a cold shower when I realized that the point and the medal were not really correlated with the learning progress of the student. And then I start noticing harmful chat messaging inside the app, in the in-app chat. And somehow the students that were scoring behind the rest of the class were somehow segregated. Even if I move away from the advertising business model, I start noticing the similar behavior I was noticing in my previous product. And the student arrive on the platform because they want to learn, improve the skill, and grow each other. But in reality, they didn't get this. They got addicted. And so I thought it was my responsibility. I feel guilty because I use their time on the product as my personal reward. And I just wanted to disappear. No, but don't appear anymore there. And to do that, when I decided that it was important for me to just use the product to enable the student relation, to support this relation that the student have already inside the school. I'm a designer, and as a designer, I rely on metrics to take decisions. And my mistake was to set up the wrong metric, because engagement was competing with the time students use to connect with their peers, with the other teachers, and with their parents. And so I wanted to change this metric. I wanted to change the total time students spend play into a metric that was more comprehensive of the full education outcome. And to do this, when I stopped looking at the activity in the app, and I start talking with the teacher. start really understanding what is the success for a student. I built several features following this new approach, and one that I'm particularly close with is the tournament. It's a 5-day tournament. One school from one part of the world has, again, another school somewhere else in the world. It's a real-life competition between schools. And some kids were very excited, particularly the one from Brazil and Ireland. Don't ask me why. But they started to set up night camp inside the school, a real night camp, imagine, with bed, food, and computer, of course, because they were playing online. And what I noticed is that the students took it as a kind of relay race. So they were all playing together and all focusing on the same things together, learning from each other, building lifelong relation, pushing and knowing more. It took me 8 months or 9 months to build an engagement product, but it took me years to evolve this one from something intrusive into something harmless, into something that had really the best interest of the user, or the student in this case, at this center. I learned to build product that people use, and I learned this one long time ago. I learned when there was no smartphone, slow internet connection, and no notification. And now these skills are harmful because technology proved to be more powerful than I thought. My fault was to act by inertia, to don't really ask myself the consequence of usage and attention. My learning so far is if we want to move away from the engagement moment, we have to start assessing and mapping the full value, the full set of human value we have in our society. I'm very early in this journey, and I have a few hypotheses. One of the hypotheses is to reduce addiction and improve outcome for us as a human. We should augment the quality of our real-life relation. And sadly, this is not an easy metric to measure. This is not something that we can just plug and play in our analytic dashboard. I think a more human internet is an horizon, is coming. But in order to drive this change, you have to start demanding to technology to help you in build stronger relation, to help you in create, in have good decision, and to help you in progressing your value. Thank you.